Hello and welcome back to EXAPUNKS. Today we're going back into the TEC EXA-BLASTER modem, and we're going to send a confusing message to a large number of pagers simultaneously. I'm ready to prove my theory. One last test is all I need, and I'll know for sure. Do you believe me? Yes. Good. Seriously, I'm always there. Then we can take the next step. Alright, so we had trouble with this one before, but we'll see what we can do. Connect to each pager and copy Ember 2's message to the screen. Then activate all pagers at exactly the same time by writing a value to each page registrar in the same cycle. A list of phone numbers for the pagers is available in file 301. 301. This shouldn't be terrible. The problem's going to be, you know, getting it to happen all at the same time. But I think I can fix that with some notes. So we'll see how that turns out. So you can go ahead and grab one and 800. You can grab 300. These are 11 digits. So you're going to mark 1 at record 11. So you you're going to void M, link 800. I don't think we can communicate if the line is broken. I'm almost 100% sure that's what that says. guess we'll have to try that. Because that ruins everything. So. I'm going to cut that. Copy negative one of the owl, and then copy 0 to M, void M. Jump in there, they dial the number, link's open, copy it over, tell him to jump across, he copies it back, tells him to hang up. Now they cannot communicate. Okay. So this has become incredibly difficult. I know I see really only one way to do this. And it feels like the only choice. So we're going to continue working, and I'm going to do this one thing that really feels like the only option I have. I'm nervous about it, but I think it'll be okay. So I guess here we go. You might not be marking one after all, but anyway. So you void there, you at rep. Copy file to data at end. Then you're going to link -1. I don't think I have. Yeah, this is gonna be something. This is gonna be something. So, how do I do this? I think the best thing to do. Test x equals 0, true jump 0. And I think we just need to continue to do that. So, copy. 4, 5, 6, 7. What? Why did that end up? I don't know why I got a new bot there. No. But yeah, we'll do 0, we'll do 1, mark 0. And this is where it's going to get a little crazy. And this might just be trial and error at this point. Because the math on this is going to be difficult. You know, we need 11 cycles for the dialing, we need however many cycles for this, you know. So, mark 0, sir, is going to... Oh my god. Okay, so we're already at 86 and we are nowhere near done. So things need to change. Each one of these is going to take at least 5 lines to work the way I need them to. And so if I translate, that's adding 40 more lines. So I'm very confused. I see a little bit of a change I can do, but it doesn't feel great. B doesn't need to jump across and do the file thing. B could just send that across global. Except that XA is waiting for a global signal, So that doesn't quite work either. We could do it all with one bot. The problem is, you know, picking the files up and putting them down. We lose our spot. Pretty sure we can't have more than one line open at a time. Yeah. Can't do it. So. Now this is a place where I could add 1x to each time. It'll increase the cycle count by crazy, but might save us some lines. That just saved us 5 lines. Yeah, that saved us 5 lines. It's the same result. So that's pretty cool. But, you know, that doesn't solve our issue right now. That's something I'm gonna have to think about, and I think it's something I want to think about off screen. I just feel like this is gonna take me a while to wrap my head around. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and make a cut here and hopefully come back to it. I'm gonna say about an hour and a half, but you know, obviously it means nothing to you because it's gonna be an instant cut. But we'll see. Alright, I am back. I have like a couple ideas, but like I don't really have the solution in my head. Like sometimes when I go away from it, I'll get the solution. I can know, okay, this is what I need to do. But that's not what I have right now. I just have a couple small ideas of things I can maybe do, but I want to rip one based on the value of X, but they're not going to let me do that. So this is where we get into trouble again. Adding 14 more, so that's way, way too much. What it could do there would be no way to really do this though. I don't think. There could be. H, okay. But you need to do. You also need to add copies. Copy 200 to X. Copy 180 to X. Copy 160 to X. These guys, are all going to do very similar things. things to one another. So they're going to grab 300. Repeating 9 times is going to be a problem, so do this a little bit differently. Do that to M instead. Yeah, we probably still do need those. Yeah, okay, I think we still do. Thank you. again. Because look, we have 7 more of these. Look at this. 3, 5. 7 times 7, 49. We have 42 left, and we're not anywhere close to done. Oh, son of a bitch. There was a command like that in Shenzhen, you could do like at something, and he would only do it one time. Getting somewhere here. We're up to 35. we have individuals. Here's my thing. Okay. So he's gonna start dialing. Copies the zero out. Who gets the zero? D got it? I feel like it's completely random who gets it. Now what you could do, have everybody on local. Everybody starts local. Okay. Except for XA, maybe? Somehow I was thinking if everybody started local. I would be able to control who comes up, but that's just simply not true. But it's just simply not true. Could have some sort of mother brain, but I feel like that's what we were doing before. Maybe having X on local could help, but it doesn't feel very helpful. How about we have B on local? Kill everybody else. Okay. And, no, he has to be global to be told to do something. So, we're going to... X plate. this 8 times. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 times. Okay? And you're probably just gonna wanna halt, honestly. Mark A is here. You are going to link 800, grab 300, link 800, at rip 9, copy file to data, at end, link 1, drop, yeah, we're gonna have to add some modes for sure. Link negative 1, drop. Link 800, and now markdown is going to be here. We're going to true jump and otherwise subby x1x jump down mark end copy 0 to hashtag page. Okay, so I'm feeling okay about this. Basically, we just need to add some modes here. So you're global, you're local. You're going to start global. So you're going to jump in, dial the thing, copy 0, copy 0 to M on the global. That's going to wake you up. So you're going to void this, copy that to this. Switch to now you can stay global, it looks like. Yeah, because you're not communicating with those guys at all, so you stay global. You copy 0 to M. And then mode void M, I suppose. That's how that's going to work. You guys jump in here, grab the data, jump here, put it in, jump back, drop it, mode. And now right now I feel like this should work, except the timing's not going to be right. We have to work on the timing, but everything else I feel pretty good about. So drop that there. Meanwhile, he starts dialing, that's fine. At the end of the file. I feel like that should happen later. copy 0 to M. This is where the shad. Yes. Okay. So there we go. Alright, so you go in there, you start dialing down, down. It's all fine. You're gonna start a connection. Copy 0 to global network, which is gonna wake up XB. He's gonna put 200 in his X-Ribster. Create a guy. And now he's just waiting for the next signal from XA. The created fellow is gonna jump in here, grab the file, jump to whatever's open. Copy the data into there. Jump back, drop the file. Switch to local mode. Tell XA to wake up again. And then jump back in. XA should have an extra thing in here. Copy -1 to dial. Let's flip up to that point. Just as he gets across, he hangs up. And then XA tests it, but he's at the end of the file. He's not, so he goes and he dials a new number. There's a new connection. Oh, no, he's got to do mode again. You might as well just stick that mode right here, because it's not going to matter much, so. Switch it back to global. XO should be, yeah, he's counting down. Everybody's in here. Here's where it becomes interesting. Whoops. Okay, I need to change that. White, grab some white. Okay. I'll change that, but here's where I'm looking at. You're at 75. You're at 93. So it's 18 cycles between each, except for that one, which is only 17. 18. 18. Everything's 18 except for these two. So the third one and the last one. So well, that would have to be the fourth one. So 25. 89, and then this one's only 17, so 72, 54, 36, 18, and then 1, I suppose, is how that's gonna work. And you, white, grab 300 white. Okay, and let's do this. Where's everybody at? XO is on 0, 0, 0, 0. Alright, I think the thing is that some of these are on jump down, so they're gonna boom, they're gonna do that. I need to make notes here. 2 and 6. plus 6, next cycle, 5 plus 1, next cycle, 4 plus 0, next cycle, 7 plus 3. Okay, so, so 0 would be U. You need to add 2, it would appear, or 2 cycles. That's going to be tough, I think. Because just adding 2, that's not going to be 2 cycles, that's going to be 2 whole sequences. Yeah, that's going to be tough. I might be able to fix this with notes, but I don't know that for sure. So it is interesting that they're all 4 apart. So the zeroth fellow is in line with the fourth fellow. That's super interesting to me. Okay, so if I add just a loop here. Let's see what that does. That put him on high with the other guys. So this is going to be kind of a trial and error sort of situation. Yeah, that added him. What was that? That's 0. That put 0 on line with everyone else. Which is this fellow. So it caught him up. But it's like we need to delay. Those 2, and then still those 3, so that didn't really do anything different, because this one delays everybody. Not that one. This one delays everybody. So that doesn't help. Let me just throw notes across the world here. Oh, that's so close. XP 0. Ooh, he's close. Those 3 all activated at the same time. 0, 1, and 2 all activated at the same exact time. 3, 4, 5, and 6 need to drop a note and a number, I think. So 1, 2, 3. So I think we do 1, 3, 5. Also drop this note. Okay, let's run this again. One cycle. So they did still need that note, it looks like. Okay. I wish I could still do it here, but I don't think I can. Six is not equal to zero. Neither. Oh, seven is way less than. So they're all cool. Six is one too far. Six needs to be 17. And he would get there. Here's the problem right now. Alright, we have an extra cut right there. My girlfriend came home and she didn't know I was recording, so a lot of background noise as she came up into this room to say hello to me. So we just cut it and we're here right where we were. I didn't do anything. As soon as I heard her first footstep, I'm like, okay, we got it. We got a situation. But this is where we are. And I think what I want to do is actually add one to all of these. We might have taken that away earlier, but now I'm going to add it. Because I think it's going to be easier. To line this up. Ooh, look at that. The longer it goes, I think it'll be easier to line it all up. Okay, and boom. Oh, wow! That actually got all of them. Whew, I didn't realize how close we were. So yeah, he's going to... He's like one behind. So honestly, I'm thinking if I can just delete this note, we might be there. We'll find out. Because that's really close. Okay, so they still got some time. Absolutely did it. And he just grabs that file, wipes it, and he's done. There you go. So, yeah, that took 4 extra minutes. If I would have had yesterday, we wouldn't have had to make that extra cut, but that's fine. So yeah, A grabs the file, jumps in. B grabs that file, jumps in. A will clear his cache. Start copying the file, and he's going to count up 11 times because that's how long the phone number is. Meanwhile, XB dropped the file, jumped back to here, and is now waiting for a signal from XA. So he dials that number out. Finally get the connection. He sends a 0 out to MA, which wakes this guy up. And he is now going to create a new guy after giving the new guy a number of cycles to wait. New guy jumps in, grabs the file, jumps there, copies the message, jumps back, drops the file, switches to local, which is why we have it happening here, because we want XB is waiting for a global signal from XA. XA is now sitting on local, waiting for a signal from him that he can dial again. So he gives him that signal, jumps back, XA hangs up, which severs this connection, and starts to dial again. Meanwhile, XO is seeing if his counter is at 0. If it's not, he takes one away, tries again. And that's the key to making them all go off at the same time. Because as he waits 125, this guy gets created, sends the thing, and starts to wait as well. And it just continues to do that. And the thing here, and this is interesting because we have one. Okay, there's no nope on the top. But everybody else gets one. That just makes it happen on the same cycle. And then, of course, the 18. 18 loops between each bot makes it so that we have enough time to dial a new number and send a new message before. That didn't happen. Oh my gosh. It happened for the first run, but not the second one. That sucks. That really sucks. Send the message out, drop the file. True jump in. What? Why? It looks like I did. What the hell? What the hell? Did I not? Send the message out. Okay. Mark zero page. Mark zero page. Mark zero page. I am activating every. What? What the hell? But I just want to see. I want to see test one again. Dial the fucking number. Come on. There you go. Okay. I'm gonna do right so now and relieved. Go do right so now and relieved. Okay. Oh. There you go. The messages are different. So it's not repeat 9 copy F data, it's something completely different. It shouldn't matter, this should be fine. We just need to make this a loop. But since every bot is going to get the same loop, this timing should remain the same. I don't see why it would. So it's going to be mark right. Okay. Test and the file. Should do it. Let me just run this one. Nope. That didn't do it. So what happens? Oh, they're just going too fast. Okay. That should be fine. Like, I think we can just add 2 to all of these. That loop is taking a lot longer than what we were doing before, so we need a couple more. We need a little bit more time here. Okay, they're already going, so we still need to add some more. Okay, so let's go 130. Well, I'm just gonna keep adding 2. remains the same, except that they're waiting longer to go off so that everybody has the time to cycle through that loop. There we go. Look out there. Oh, they're still going. They're still going off. And six still has nine to go? Damn. Seven has four to go. So seven just got there. Man, so I'm gonna have to add 10 more after that? I think I might. 40. 22. These guys are still going off. Something's wrong. Something is way wrong. Why would adding 10? Oh, it's the... So, fuck. It's not... It's not the total amount they have, it's the distance between the amounts that's the problem. I don't know about that. I don't know if I agree with this at all. Because if this guy's waiting an extra, where was he? He was at like 108, right? Something like that? No, he was at 108. So you were at 126. So if we're waiting an extra 14 cycles now, why does it make sense? Why does it make sense that this guy's not even created yet? Seven. On the last one, seven was here. But now you're telling me this asshole went through 140 before seven even got created? That doesn't make any sense at all. There's seven getting created now. This doesn't make any sense. Okay, stop. Just stop. Okay. We're going to flip out here. Okay, XO, you have 140, and you're... on your thing. So he dropped about 27? That's actually a really good... Let's see. Okay, so we're going to create this guy. So... he's gonna come in here, he's gonna write the message, and what I wanna see, see by command the ways, question mark, send that out. Okay. So at link negative one, no, not there, drop, mode, copy. So at his first test is what I want. Let's see. So we're at 140. You're gonna dial up the new number. Can you see the ways? Question mark? So at his first test. We're off now. You know, you're a true jump in. He's on test, which is shitty. But that was 28 cycles. So that would mean, by my count, that if this guy is at 0, then we need 28, 56, 84, 112, 140, 168, and then finally 196. That's my math on that. So down here, everybody's looking good. Looks like I was gonna have to write a thing. That guy just started. Boom, 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 boom. Everybody's off by one note now. But here's the thing. If we go back to test run number one, let me see. These guys have started. These guys are way the fuck behind. So this doesn't work at all because the messages are of different lengths, and therefore the loop takes longer to go through, and therefore we are completely screwed. So alright, let me talk about the problems right now. Let me talk about what I'm thinking right now, because silence is not good for these types of videos. So, here is what I'm thinking. The messages are different lengths, therefore I can't have each individual bot sending the messages. It just wouldn't work. So, like, what I need... As far as I'm thinking, what I need to do is send all the messages and then create the little bots. So we send every message, we create the bots. And we would have to have them all link. Here's the problem. It's actually not a huge problem. It would be link, hang up, link, hang up, link, hang up. And so basically we just need each bot to have maybe one, you know, maybe one cycle per, or maybe just some notes, depending. But the problem is the size here. To do this at 100 is very questionable. But this right here, what I've done, does not work. It is without merit. So unfortunately, I am going to completely destroy it, and we are going to start over. So deciding right now, do I want to start over right now, or do I want to take a small break? And I think the answer is small break. I think I want a very small break. I'm going to try my best to make sure it's a small break. But yeah, that's what I'm looking for. So, another cut, and I will see you guys very soon. Alright, I am back. That was a very short break, but this is going to be a very short segment as well. I just put my lunch in the oven, and so now I have about 28 minutes to work. And so that's what I'm going to do. oh, how did I do that? I keep doing this thing. It must be Control Enter?
Yeah.
That's what it does. Okay. Six, seven, eight. Mark A. I could probably put out. question. That's the activation. Let's see. We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so we activated at 7:10. Just do it like that. We activated at 7:10. They dial a new number. At 7:62, we activated. So 52 cycles need to pass between each one. So, if we write out a loop, it's not really divisible by 52, which is an issue. That's threes. Let's just try to do the work here and just see where we're at, and then we'll fix it the same way we tried to fix before. So void M. These are threes, and we need, I'm gonna say, start around just 80 just to see where we're at. X. Copy. So 1 to X. Copy. 62 to X. Are still starting, which is incredible. the dial's gonna be the same. You avoid him. Copy it in. Replicate that. Tell him to hang up.
This one took a long time.
24 minutes on my timer right now of 28, so that's pretty awesome. So yeah, we don't need much of the top through here. They grab the files, they jump across. XA clears this cache, starts to dial. Sends a signal to XB that it's okay to cross. XB crosses, puts the message in, comes back, tells XA it's okay to dial. He hangs up, dials a new number, and that's just what they continue to do. Once he hits the end of the file, this is the difference. I had been trying to leave the replicants in there, but what I changed here is that we send the message, we have him hang up. This guy realizes it's the end of the file. He tells XB it's the end of the file, and that has them both switch down to the second half of their commands, where he's going to go back to the beginning. He's going to start dialing again, and XB is going to start creating replicants with timers on. So the number gets dialed, XB gets that signal, puts a timer in his X register, replicates a guy who will take that timer with him, tells XA to hang up while the replicant jumps across, and now the replicant is going to start counting down on that timer. Now while XA dials a new number, and the same thing happens 8 times. And just through a little bit of trial and error, we got the timing down to 18 cycles, or 18 loops apart from one another, so they all end up staged in here with one to go. Successful test run. Like I said, I could have just changed the command, so instead of searching for equal to zero, I could have searched for less than one, which would have worked, but honestly, it doesn't look like it makes that much of a difference, because it simply doesn't. It maybe adds 3 cycles to the thing, because it would be subtract 1 would still be there. I don't think I would change that without risking breaking things. So subtract 1 is still going to be there. Test is equal to. No, it doesn't save any cycles at all, unless I change the way the code was orientated, which I wouldn't bother doing. So no, I was wrong about that. But I was right about being able to solve this puzzle. I knew I could, it just took me a long time. Pretty difficult one. I don't actually know how long this video is going to end up being because of how many cuts I had to do. But cycle count's a bit high, size is really high, activity is right on what most people do, and there you go. Again, not really sure why some of these take longer. I don't quite get that. Oh, no, the length of the message, that would be why. Okay, fascinating. There it is. Well, what did you find? How can I explain it? Processing. Think of it as a frame rate of the world slowing down by a lot. Funny, huh? Funny how it went from some random pop go that didn't know anything devastating all of existence. I get to know what you found out? I will. Didn't you get a weird pager message?
Nope,
don't have a pager. It made no sense. When did everything just stop making sense? I'm trying to think. Things that ever make sense. I feel like something changed lately. This is what I've been talking about. It's like reality is falling apart. Or you're falling apart. And that is the end of this. Oh, a meeting. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
So you wanted to know the truth. The truth is that, well, it's a simulation. You, me, everything, this whole world we live in. It's just a computer program. And as the world gets more complex, it's starting to malfunction. So far, it's been on a smaller scale. The phage, for one example. It wasn't supposed to spread like this. There are other problems coming. Larger ones. What we think of as normal life will just get stranger and weirder until nothing makes sense anymore. Then the laws of physics will start to break down and everything will just come unglued. Not a pretty sight. But we don't have to accept that. There might be a way to stop this future from taking place. I have one final job for you, but you'll have to be brave.
Final job? Oh my goodness. Heads up, all. I'm gonna reboot the chat server. Some downtime expected. Okay. Woo! Something wrong? Nothing particular, just general weirdness, like everywhere. I'm heading to bed anyway. Night, everyone. See ya. Thanks for the help. Now it's a good time to start my epic rant. See y'all later. You have disconnected from Xbox. And we have to build an interface to bridge number two with our cerebral cortex. But of course, that's going to be next time. I'm already 30 minutes on the timer. I'm a little bit late. I hope my lunch is not burned. I will see you all very soon. Take care. Bye-bye.